MedCram.
Welcome to part two of acute renal failure. Let's review a little bit here about what we were talking about. We were talking about Chem 7. We have the BUN. And we've got the creatinine. The BUN stands for the blood urea nitrogen. Remember, it's made in the liver. It is both filtered and reabsorbed, whereas the creatinine is the end product of muscle metabolism, and it is filtered and secreted. So let's look at our nephron once again. That's the loop of Henle. That's distal convoluted tubule, collecting duct, and you've got the toilet down here. Okay, and you've got the afferent and the efferent arteriole. And remember what we said about the BUN. BUN is the blood urea nitrogen. It goes through and also gets reabsorbed. Okay, so that's BUN. And you've got the creatinine. Creatinine does not get reabsorbed, but instead goes out. Actually, a little bit gets secreted here. Okay, so if you've got acute renal failure, remember that the GFR, the glomerular filtration rate, is going to go down. So if that's the case, then your BUN is going to go up, just because of the fact that the glomerular filtration rate is lower, therefore not as much as being filtered, the BUN is going to go up. But because it's going by slower because the GFR is down, then more of it is going to be reabsorbed, and so it's going to go up by even more. That's opposed to the creatinine. Creatinine is going to go up. Why? Because the GFR is low, and the GFR is low because there's acute renal failure going on, and that means that creatinine is going to go up, but it's not going to go up any more than that because it's not being reabsorbed. And so what you see here is that the BUN goes up more than the creatinine does when you have a decrease in your GFR, just based on the fact that there's lower flow. So lower flow means higher BUN to creatinine ratio. Okay, so what would be a number here that we could associate with it? So normal would be, for instance, 15 over 1. So if the BUN over creatinine, if the BUN went up by more than that of the creatinine, we could say, for instance, that this would go to a 2 and a 30. Okay? So the BUN would go up to 30 and the creatinine would go up to 2. So you go up by, instead of having a 15 to 1 ratio, you would have more like, instead of even 30, it would even go up higher, it would go to 40. So a 40 to 2 ratio, which is the same as a 20 to 1 ratio. So here we would see the normal ratio is 15 to 1 and it would go up to 20 to 1, or in this case, 40 over 2. And that would be from a low flow state. Now, what would happen here if for some reason there was a shutdown? A different type of acute renal failure. Acute renal failure, not because there's less flow coming to the glomerulus, but instead because the actual tubules which line the nephron, something we call renal failure, if they weren't working. Well, what would happen is that you would still get a slowdown here because these cells are not working and the BUN would go up. But it would only go up for one reason, and that's because the GFR is low. You would not get reabsorption of this BUN. And so what you would have is, this would be more of a pre-renal. What I mean by that is that there is a reduction in the flow coming here, and because of that, you're getting the BUN increasing because of the low flow, and also the BUN is being reabsorbed because these cells are working. So that would be a pre-renal situation. Or in a renal situation, these cells are not working. And so if these cells are not working, the flow is going to be low as a result of that, but you're not going to get BUN reabsorption. And so it's going to go up, instead of being 15:1, okay, it's going to go to 30:2, which is still the same 15:1 ratio, but they're both going up, but this is not going up more than that is, so it still holds the same ratio. So in a renal situation where there's a problem with the kidney itself, you hold and maintain that 15:1 ratio. But when there is a pre-renal state, in other words, there's not enough flow coming to the glomerulus, you're going to get a reabsorption of the BUN preferentially, and that's going to increase your BUN ratio to 20:1. Okay, so the bottom line here is that the BUN to creatinine ratio can kind of tell you what kind of renal failure you have. Is it pre-renal azotemia or is it renal azotemia? Pre-renal azotemia is where there's not enough blood coming to the kidney. Renal azotemia is where there's something wrong with the kidney itself. If it's 20:1 ratio like this, you're thinking of pre-renal azotemia. If it's still 15:1 ratio, it's renal azotemia. Okay, another way of looking at that is just looking at sodium and water concentration. So let's go ahead and draw our glomerulus again. A little bigger this time. Here's the glomerulus, the proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, and then out. Okay, so pretend you're a nephron, and you've got two different situations. You've got a situation where you have a pre-renal situation where there is not enough blood coming in to the kidney, and you've got a renal situation where there's a problem with the actual tubules that are supposed to be transporting fluids and reabsorbing. In a pre-renal situation, there's not enough blood coming in, and you have a reduction in your GFR. Well, the kidney thinks that there's not enough volume. And the way the kidney regulates volume is by reabsorbing sodium. So if there's not enough volume, all the kidney's going to do is just try to reabsorb more sodium. And so what's going to happen to your urine that's coming out? You think it's going to be high in sodium or low in sodium? Well, it's going to be very low in sodium in a pre-renal situation. And of course, as sodium goes up, guess what else comes with it? Water. And so are you going to have a lot of water in the filtrate, in the urine that's coming out? The answer is no. So you're going to be very low in sodium and very low in water. So that leaves a high concentration or a high osmolarity to the urine that's coming out. Okay, let's look at the flip side of that. Again, here's our glomerulus. Glomerulus, proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, and collecting tubule going out to the toilet down below. Okay, so in this situation, we've got a renal problem. The renal problem is that these cells are not reabsorbing. In fact, none of them are reabsorbing. There's a problem all over. And so what's the situation here? Here we've got plenty of fluid coming to the kidneys, but because these cells are not working, all of that sodium and water is just going right through and out. So we would expect to see a high sodium concentration, a high water concentration, and therefore a low osmolarity to the fluid. And that's in renal, when there's a problem with renal. Okay, so let's summarize once again. Make sure everyone's on the same page here. So we've got the BUN. Okay, what are some of the points that we learned about the BUN? It's synthesized in the liver. Okay, it's filtered and absorbed. Okay. What are things that can increase it that have nothing to do with the kidney? We've talked about that. We've talked about fever. We've talked about GI bleeding. Okay. There's antibiotics like tetracycline. There is catabolic effects, steroids, all that. What are some things that can decrease it? Well, liver failure. Okay. And then what about proximal convoluted tubule? We see there. We see that it parallels the reabsorption of sodium and water. And so we know that it's reabsorbed. Okay. And so because of that, in a low flow state, it's going to be really absorbed. So it's going to go up. Okay. Now, what about creatinine? All right, we know that it's the end product of muscle and that it is filtered and secreted. Okay, so what are some things that can increase it that have nothing to do with the kidney function? We know that it can be increased by drugs that prevent its secretion in the kidney, and that would be cimetidine and trimethoprim. What are some things that can decrease it? Muscle wasting. Okay, and we know that it goes up in renal failure. Okay, well, let's talk about the BUN to creatinine ratio. We know that because the BUN goes up even higher in a low flow state, that it's usually 20 to 1 ratio if it's prerenal. Prerenal, again, is any reason that causes a decrease in blood flow to the kidneys, and that it's 15 to 1 in renal. Okay, and in renal, remember, is where there's a problem with the kidney itself, and prerenal is where there's a problem with the amount of blood flow that's going to the kidney. Okay, now, join me for part 3 for the final wrap-up of acute renal failure. Thanks for joining me.